So Islam is not saying don't have a dunya, but Islam is saying how can you have a dunya without an akhirah? That's a moderate, balanced approach. But Islam will also look down upon you and speak lowly of you if you only live for the dunya. You are created for ibadah. You are created for the hereafter. You are created to be in Jannah. And all of these things, they don't lead there. All of these things, they help you have a good life here. How long are you living for exactly? The entire world is short. The time you are living in it is even shorter. And the time that has elapsed from your life is even shorter than this. What are you building? What are you investing into? What if it crashes? What if it fails? What if the displeasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is upon you? Have you ever thought about it like this?
Hey, see what's left of my rice.
Allah says, look, we created you on earth. We did not guarantee you that you're going to have it smooth sailing. In fact, we will test you one after the other. Life is not going to be smooth. You will have a day when you suffer and you think to yourself, when is this going to end? So Allah says, when we put hardship in your life, it is in order to bring you closer to us and in order to realize the temporary nature of this world. If that happens, Allah says, with the patience that you endure, we will give you a good death and we will give you eternal bliss of paradise.
Ta-da! Alhamdulillah, food is ready.